There we go. Good lord, that's funny. Okay, cool. Awesome, there we go. That was comical. But we are live again. It's like nothing happened.
That's because nothing did.
Absolutely nothing. Mon Dieu. Sacré mou. Alright. Oh dear. Oh, hold on. Okay. Oh dear. There we go. Let me get the filters at the ready, because that seems to be making all the difference in how this stream looks. It's a bit of a mess. Let's go. WookieFragger! I still regret that I didn't call this file fuck. Per Andy's suggestion, and against my instincts, oddly enough. Yes. Sewers of the Imperial City. What's interesting here is it shows some of these boxes stacked catty-corner, and that's definitely not how it went in that level, so. Gotta love those pre-rendered images. Showing you things that just don't happen in the game. It's charming, really. Oh dear. Don't I have to go to work? I went to work, and then it started storming out. And so a coin was flipped, and I won the coin toss, and I came home. So that's how that shook. So I did, and until I didn't. Now you're going out to dinner? Well, I hope you enjoy your dinner. I hope it's delicious and nutritious and not from someplace suspicious. You would have changed your plans. Ah, fuck. I'm sorry. I'll tell you what, one of these days I will have to do this game on hard, so you won't miss that. Skipping Luke. So rude. Hey, I didn't think it was gonna work out. To be honest, I feel like they could have made the decision a little bit sooner. But they were busy dealing with a new system for taking orders outside. They had mobile handsets brought in, and so I think that they were a little bit busy, kind of coming to grips with that. Working out the kinks in that system, so they weren't really paying attention to other things, like what the weather was like. Oh shit! Oh no, the rail one I already made through earlier. Oh shit, I don't want to use the disruptor. I picked up the disruptor on the Imperial freighter. The train level is pretty awesome, though. The train level is... The music from the train level gets stuck in my head all the time. I actually feel like they used the music better in the train level than they did in the film it comes from. I think that track originally appears in Empire Strikes Back, but it works better in this game. Whoa, shit. Heating up a little bit more coffee. And I gotta make sure not to burn myself again. That was the worst part of the day. Ooh. And I think Francis was right when he said earlier, I'm going to have some smooth skin growing in. Because that was not fun. Ooh, shit. Yeah, we're good. Cool. Nothing like a little bit of burning. Crap. Nah, I do wish I had known earlier that I wouldn't be working tonight. I didn't have a single table. Definitely put something on it. Yeah. Yeah, I did that earlier. Ran my hand under some cold water, and it'll peel, but it'll be fine. I've definitely burned my hand worse than this. Ah, oh, you fucker. Okay, I'm gonna switch to first person because I don't have the instincts for, like, the speed that Dathrendar turns. Ah, oh, damn. I should have jetpacked, though. I like that this level begins you with the jetpack, but I don't understand why the Imperial Freighter, he doesn't have it. Because the jetpack is awesome. To be honest, so we've talked about sewer levels before. I think the reason this sewer level is better than, like, Dark Forces sewer level is entirely because of the jetpack. Gotta run a 630 res. Might watch more if I'm still on later. Okay. You feel like you don't remember this level either. This level is later on in the game. This is kind of far along. Like, this is... I'm close to the end of the game at this point. Like, this and I think the next level are the last on-foot sections. Oh shit, I gotta be careful. Yeah, there we go. Whoa, shit! I am back. You know, I did have work, but I work... I was supposed to be working an outdoor dining section, and we just got rained and thunderstormed out, so there's, like, no point. The super dark... You know what? Here, let me do this. That's better. And yeah, the other game, the other fucking Star Wars game I played... had a really super dark sewer level. Dark Forces has a miserable sewer level in it. A crime against level design. This game's sewer level ain't that bad. Oh my gosh. No work, all play. Thank you very much. Whoa, there we go. Oh, much obliged. You got rained out. You got rained too? Are you? Oh shit, wait. Oh crap. I know that roaring sound. This must have the fucking monsters in it. The sewer monsters that are in the other game. Yeah, I see them. Ah, fuck. There it is. See, this game's sewer level is not that different from the other one. But it really is the presence of, like, the fucking... It's the jetpack that makes this one bearable. Actually going, good luck. Andy, thank you very much for stopping by. I wish I could have shown you more of this today. But it's always good to see you. I'll catch you later, man. Canadian duck. You're Eastern time, right? I seem to remember you telling me that you were an East Coaster at one point. I can't remember. But I'm pretty sure. Live in Toronto, okay. I figured it was not, you know... I figured by the name that it probably wasn't gonna be the U.S. But okay, so Toronto, Canada. All right. I have been up that way, but it has been most of my life since the last time. Let me look this up. Springwater Valley. Is that what it is? No, I know what I'm looking for. Hold on. God. Yeah. God, there was a fucking, there's this place that my parents would vacation, and so I would go there with them. And it was a resort. Looks like it's in Ontario. Okay. There's a resort in Ontario that was called Catholic Land Retreat Center. And they would vacation there, like, every year or every other year for a while. So... Yeah. Yeah, so I've been up that way before, but it's been a very long time. I'm pretty sure I've been to Toronto, but haven't heard of that spot? Okay. I mean, Ontario, like, I guess that makes sense. Ontario is probably way bigger than Maryland. I forget sometimes that my reference point for what the size of places are is a little off, because Maryland, everything is like, every part of Maryland is at most 2 hours away from anywhere else you are. You know, most of the time, if I ever have to go anywhere or get something done, it's like a 10-minute drive. So I would imagine Ontario is way bigger than Maryland. Ooh. I need health. Oh my god. Badly. And I'm glad I just put on the same filter that I had for Doom 64. Just to be able to see. Okay, got the pulse cannon. I love that the jetpack works underwater. That's cool. But yeah, I would imagine Catholic Land doesn't have much interest unless you are Catholic. It wasn't always called Catholic Land. Kind of makes it sound like a fucking like Busch Gardens or Hershey Park or something. But it used to be the place was called Springwater Valley Resort, I think. You know, the people who owned it were very Catholic and decided that they wanted the name to match their feelings, and so Catholic Land was, for lack of a better word, christened. Yeah, that's where I go. I have a feeling, though, that there's more down here. Hold on. Let me see. Yeah, there's a life in here. Let's get it. A challenge point and a fucking life. Hell yeah. Alright. It's that cobblestone texture that's in every game. Andy sent me a video on texture archaeology. It's basically people who go through games and they identify all of the photographic sources of stock video game textures that you see in games. So they've identified, like, this cobblestone texture that's everywhere. And they identified what adds the shiny, like, different colors to the Metal Mario reflection. Oh shit, I have 69 health, I just realized. That's amazing. No, they identified, oh shit. That his reflection his reflection is basically, or the reflection that you see of Mario. It is pretty cool. It is pretty cool. The reflection that you see on Mario's Metal Mario skin is actually like a fisheye lens view of a flower garden, but it's so heavily compressed that for a long time people couldn't tell what it was. I'm gonna look up the video and I'm gonna paste a link to it, because it's really neat. I'm gonna texture archaeology. Yeah, the most overused game graphic you never noticed. It was this video right here. It was about cobblestone. And like I usually obsess over over like sound elements. Like I can instantly identify when I've heard something from a sound library across multiple games and movies. It could be like the most mundane, underused sound effect. So not just like, you know, that door sound effect or that crashing glass sound effect, but like really random shit. I start to identify like certain gunshots used in games, and it's just like, and that's just because I'm very auditory. I tend to memorize sounds really, really easily. Because I always have mimicked sounds. It's just a weird habit I've had, but we give it a watch. Wilhelm Scream, for instance. Yeah, Wilhelm Scream is a good instance. It's a good example. It's just something that's been around the block, and you know, it serves its function very well. Although at this point, the Wilhelm Scream is used more often as a joke, because people have gotten so used to the sound of it. This is kind of an awkward bit of platforming right here. Totally doable, but fuck. Damn it! Oh, shit! Damn, that was not good. Fuck. Damn this thing! It's really hard to manage your fucking corners in this game. Damn it! And it's like, Jesus. I'm not even sure how you're supposed to avoid some of these. No, the game's just like, I bone you now. Well, I'll get the challenge point. Fuck it. I was that close, and I didn't know, so... bastards. Ooh, there we go. Everything looks red. I don't like it. I mean, those guys look red, but they also are red, so it's fine. Fuck! Oh, see? That's what I'm fucking talking about. Like, how am I supposed to not get hit by that? I don't know. Why don't you complain about it some more, Tim? That'll help. Ah. I love the Wilhelm Scream. And it's like, that sound effect was everywhere, but I don't think it was until... It was probably Star Wars where, like, people really started to notice it. And that's just because everybody watched Star Wars, like, 100 times. Hmm. You found the security key that will access the main sewage gate. Yes, I did. Now, where do I go? Oh, no, wait, I gotta go back out of this puzzle here. There we go. Awesome. Sounds like something else is moving, though. 1,000 times. Hey, Carl, what's up, man? Yeah, so it turns out that I don't have to work anymore today. I had to apply the same filter that I used for Doom 64 because this level is about that dark. So the colors are kind of fucked up, but at least you can see what's happening. Here we go, that's what I gotta do. If you told me you had seen Star Wars 1,000 times, I would absolutely believe you. I may have seen Return of the Jedi about that many times. I have no idea. Just the number of times I rewatched it as a kid. I did destroy a tape just from, like, watching it so many times. May the Fourth be with you, too. Yeah, I watched this shit the first tape was, it was well before the special editions, so, it was the original cut. It was full screen, though. I didn't actually see Star Wars in widescreen until my dad took me to see the, special edition, like, the re-release in theaters. But, I consider myself very lucky because I have seen, at this point, every single Star Wars movie in theaters. Even if the version of A New Hope that I saw was, the recut version with, Greedo shooting first, hardly mattered to me as a kid. I get the ire behind that, as an adult, but, But ultimately, it is still Star Wars. That version of the film is still fucking Star Wars, and the sheer fun of the movie is undeniable. That level was hard on the eyes, like that red dust. Yes, like the red dust planet and Dark Forces. That was. That was. The footage of that didn't look good. Actually playing that level didn't look good. That was just an eye bleeder right there. That's the only part of that game that I think actually looks better in DOSBox on, like, an LCD screen. Which is something that I never find myself saying. But, like, at LCDs do not burn your eyes out the same way that that a CRT will. Here we go. Ah, that's what I gotta do. Throw this. Oh, what? Oh. Shit. Right. Okay. Damn. One. Okay. Need to find a force field generator. I think I did. No, I think I didn't. Okay. No, I gotta keep going. This fucking thing! There we go. Blah. But yeah, I'm aiming to watch some Star Wars tonight. When I get off stream. I have not overdosed yet today. Okay. Jetpack over to the other switch. Okay, now what did that do? That did this. Is that the force field key? It is! It's a force field deactivator. Cool. It's a remote control. Well, maybe not a remote control. I gotta, like, come up to it. Alright, let's hit him with the Seeker. Oh, no, damn it. That one's not closed yet. And they have a shot on me when it's open. That's cheeky. Die, please. Thank you. Saving that disruptor, though. Perfect. We got three tunnels to go down here. Ooh. Damn it! I mean, I know that this level just killed me, but as far as sewer levels go, I don't hate this yet. And it really is all about the jetpack. Like, you put a jetpack in a game, and it makes every level that you play with that jetpack better. I would say Shadows of the Empire might have the best sewer level I've ever played. Because, yeah, there's some platforming. I don't mind the platforming. There's a little bit of bullshit. It's fine. But I have a jetpack. I have a jetpack, and it's hard to get lost in this level. It's Dark Forces sewer level with, like, the literal rivers of shit. That is just, like, too much. Rivers of shit and pitch darkness. These are the things I come to Star Wars for. I'm bitching too much. This time I'm spending complaining could be spent wiping out the Empire. Yeah, here we go. Oh, that's what I need. Is there a boss? There is a boss! Yes! I have to fight, like, the great big, like, tentacle monster that looks like it came right out of Half-Life. Yep, okay, there we go. Dianoga Eye, okay. Oh, shit! Nope. Alright, I'll get it. Die, please. Come on! Whew! That thing is huge! And I died! Damn it! One life. Where's the eye? There you are. Die! Please! Fucking... No. Okay. Shit! It's dead. Come on. Float! And don't die. If it's brown, send it down. Damn right. Dark Forces meets Shawshank Redemption. Yes. The defeat of this monster... I Half-Life, when you go to the blast pit and you destroy that one green tentacled thing, and what's left are these severed stumps, it always made me think of this. From the trash compactor, yes! But this one looks way bigger. It looks way bigger than the one that, Luke faced. Like, the eye of this thing was huge! Alright, who's here? Alright, I'm alive. I'm just... Okay, I made it! Good! Lord, all right. Ah! Okay. Two lives, four, here we go! The colors are all off. Filters. And yet, if I were to fucking... tweak that too much. Okay. Sir, there are several service panels to the... Ah, God. Sir, there are several service panels to the space elevator that connects Shizor's palace to his skyhook in orbit. Yes. If you place pulse bombs on each of these three service panels, the fortress will be destroyed, and the skyhook will be cut off. I'm too imprecise to be a robot. That's looking a little better, I think. Something about the contrast is still funky, but... that looks about right. That looks about right. I'm keeping the sliders open right here. Alright. Ooh, hello. Bam, alright. I still have the one disruptor round. And I'll get more, assuming I don't get myself killed at all. Well, even if I get killed, actually. Because I forget your equipment carries over, which is one of the nice things about this. Yeah, like, Dark Forces had Dianogas as well. Which is weird to see Dianogas on so many different planets. Kind of makes me wonder how they get around. Or actually, if they're part of the trash system, then they must be like a parasite, and they must grow to all sorts of different sizes. So if anywhere spaceships dock, now that I think about it, are places where Dianogas would have chance to grow. Oh, fuck. Larger ships, I would think, though. Ships large enough to have, like, trash rooms. Fuck! Okay, well, got another disruptor, but fuck. You dead? Yes, the music here rules. It kind of feels very kung fu movie, you know? And also the room design. Shit. Damn it. Okay, I don't trust this. One of these columns has a switch on it. Where was it? Nope, I'm thinking of upstairs, and I need to jump. I need to jump right into the health and not waste any time moving around. Nice of them to give me exactly as much as I need, though. Oh, maybe not exactly. Yes, I remember this texture right here that is also from Dark Forces. Shit! I really wish there was some way to test my pet theory about this being a fork of the Dark Forces engine. Shit. Damn robots! Shit! Fuck! Shit! Kinda cool looking. I love shiny, untextured N64 things. Fuck! That is untextured, isn't it? I can't actually tell. If it's untextured, or if it has a ribbon texture, or if that ribboning is just some weird property of its, you know, chrome-ness. The soundtrack that the composer made for this is awesome. You have the soundtrack, Joel McNeely. Yes. I have the PC version of this game from GOG. I'm not sure if that version comes with the soundtrack. But, yeah, this music is great, I agree. He scored the Young Indiana Jones Chronicles, that's interesting. That was a TV series, right? He based the score on scenes from the Shadows of the Empire book. That's pretty forward-thinking, honestly. And that works really well for the game. And I'm kind of surprised that we've never gotten even, like, an animated Shadows of the Empire movie. It seems like the kind of thing that they could do, and if Shadows of the Empire was one of their projects now, it seems like one of the things that they would have done. Whoa, shit! Fuck. I would watch that. Shit! There we go. Ah, god damn! Of course. Yeah, I'll get ya. These checkpoints are a little far. At least all the enemies stay dead. Die! Ooh, shit. Oh, fuck, there we go. Like, the impression that I get is that the inspiration for the Black Sun criminal syndicate is, like, basically the Yakuza. You have the soundtrack. Oh, gotcha! Oh, that's awesome. Like on CD, vinyl? Could you pop it in and play Quake and create a totally new experience? I'm absolutely not joking. That would be so much fun. Oh, shit. Damn, this guy was already walking. Okay. There we go. Oh, I can't. Okay. I could make it down, but there's really not much reason to do it. Is it just me, or does it kind of look like he has the Quake logo on his jetpack? They made comics for the story, had a book, and this game. Yeah. Yes. I remember that there were comics, and that there was a novel. I never got the chance to read those. My entire Shadows of the Empire experience has just been the game. Shit. Motherfucker, come on. But it was cool because, like, and I think this, if I'm remembering this right, it was because of public engagement with Shadows of the Empire that they ended up going full steam ahead with the Star Wars prequels. It was like a multimedia project that was supposed to test the waters to see if it was a good time to bring Star Wars back to the theaters. And the results were very much, yes, do it. But I wish that I had I wish I were more of a reader when I was a kid. Because I didn't really start to appreciate comic books until I was a teenager, but at that point, like, access was an issue. But the Shadows of the Empire comic is something I would love to read. You know, I also would really like to read the Timothy Zahn, the Thrawn novels. I would love to do that. So I've heard a lot about them. And, like, it's Star Wars, and I love Star Wars. I just want to have something really good to read, you know? They look like the ones they added to the special edition scenes of Tatooine. Yes! You know what? You're right, it does look like that. That makes sense. Wah. Fuck. Die. Yeah, that totally looks like that. I got a stunner. Cool. It's blue because it's stone cold. I guess I go... Ah, fuck. Come on. Yeah, I go this way. Shit! Everything is a little bit high stress. Oh, man. Oh, man! Whoa! Oh, that's all bad. That was not good. I don't want that to happen again. If we could not do that, I would be pretty grateful. Damn it. Come on! All right, one down. How do I, like, not get hurt by that fucking thing? I swear to God. Oh well, disruptor ammo. One life. And that droid looked a little bit like HK-47 from, Knights of the Old Republic, that's what it's called. Jeez. Star Wars has, like, the best robot designs. What? Oh, it's you. You got the sneaky stuff. So sneaky. Oh, hello. What is this? I'll take that. And let's go this way. Cool. We're out. Cool. Okay, there's nothing there. Let's go. Check your corners, Tim. Shit! Always get me! At least a little bit. There's no scot-free in this game. Oh, God! Yeah, can we not do the whole shooting me? Yeah, fuck you. Is he dead? No! He survived that! And I had to finish him off, damn! Yeah. Via the Rebels animated series. I remember a lot of fans being, like, really happy when that happened. Crap. Is there anything down here that I can grab? Nope. Just corpses. Bah. Bastards. Alright, let's fly. Up we go! Thank you. I'll take that. Ooh. Try not to fall, Tim. Okay, that has been gotten, yes? Yes, it has. That's why it looks like that. So now I must go up. And it looks like there's a person up there who is fixing to shoot at me. Now they don't get... Oh my god. Yo! He lived through that shit and killed me! Oh my god! Should I be mad? Like, what the fuck? That was kind of incredible. Bullshit. But amazing. Oh, yeah. Aren't you special? Fuck you, buddy. Wow. That's Jesus. Let me see that. What is that? 46? 32. I gotta timestamp that. That's nuts. Yeah. Seconds in. Some of the craziest shit I've ever seen in this game. He fell all the way down. I did not know when I entered this room that I was gonna be put up against, like, the Chuck Norris of fucking Imperial Stormtroopers. Wanna hear what happened a couple hours ago? Sure. What happened a couple hours ago? Welcome back, by the way, Maslin. Wee. So you're a kid who got lost because you're short and you have a bit of a baby face. Okay. Is this... Ah, there's some health. What?! You had to assure them that you weren't lost. Oh no, what? Wait, did he call the police because he thought you were a missing child? Is that what happened? Oh my god! Dude, that... Oh my god! How long did it take to clear that up? That's nuts! The pulse bombs are set, and Luke has found Princess Leia. Just find a way out. It sounds like that robot has a cold the way I'm voicing him. Should have not chased him. I know, but... bastards got to pay. If there's one lesson I should have learned from The Last Jedi, it's that I'm not going to win by destroying what I hate, but by saving what I love. I did not adequately learn that lesson, it would seem. But, you know, my failure did teach me something, and failure is the greatest teacher. Or, sorry, the greatest teacher failure is. Today has been interesting. Yeah, it sounds fucking interesting. That might be the one I watch today. Because I probably will only have time for one. Oh, I kind of want to watch Rise of Skywalker again, too. I'm all over the place. I should roll the dice and see what Star Wars movie I get. Ah. Here we go. I'm so disappointed in myself. I am down to... Oh, shit. Okay. Alright. Well, this is gonna be interesting. Gotta kill this thing now. And not die in the attempt. At least he seems to turn slowly. Gladiator, huh? I don't know, man. I'm kind of upsettiator. Seems to be pretty easy to kill from here. Ah, shit! No, don't you get ready to fire that shot. Don't you dare. Stop it! I'm leaning the wrong way. Why am I doing this? Yeah, I'll finish him off this way. Actually, I should also use the stunner. Oh, that did fucking nothing. Good to know. Alright. It is disruptor time. Ewok's Caravan of Courage. No, I'm okay. Oh, shit! Fuck! Oh! Whoa! Hey! Hey! Oh, shit! Crap! Oh, that's bullshit. Oh, no! Oh, no! Oh, shit! Oh, crap! Yeah, that was overkill, and now the missiles. Fuck. Shit! And I'm fucking dead with no lives! Damn it! That's a game over! It's fine. It's fine. I just gotta go all the way through Shizor's palace again. It's linear, it's not like I'm gonna get lost. Ah, that fucking sucked, though. Damn it. Is Ewok's Caravan of Courage on Disney Plus? So if it is, I might actually do that. If it's not long. If it's not long, I see no reason not to. Whoa! Whoa! Come on, you! Oh, I'm so fucking mad. At least I have the disruptor shot that I walked into this level with. I can just get through this quick. I can get through this quick, and as long as I don't, like, chase down the guys that fall. It's very useful to know that the enemies don't take fall damage if they walk off the edge. So that will just get me killed. Oh my god, stop! Stop! Shit. I'm hurt. Time to run! Fuck! Who the fuck's shooting at me? It's this interrogation droid. You fucking shithead. There we go. I still think I'm swearing too much for this Star Wars game. Alright. We got this. Okay, moving forward. Boom. Run. Thank you. Die, robot! Yes, do a weird front flip. Do it! Awesome. They're both now in the Star Wars Vintage Collection. Okay. I have one of the Star Wars Droids cartoons on tape still. Shh. And I can't sit through it. I have tried. Ah, crap. I can normally find myself charmed by things that are, like, expressly for kids, but the droids cartoon just does not do it for me. Fuck. I think it's because it's the kind of thing that I could tell that even if I was a kid watching it, like, I would feel like the animation just, like, was not done with heart. I was kind of a cynical child. The things... The ways I could have been happier in life. It's fine. It's fine. It's one of the things that makes me happy is Star Wars. And there is so much of it. Die! Fuck! Okay, this motherfucker. Okay. Battle for Endor. And the original Boba Fett cartoon from the Star Wars Holiday Special. Oh, I've seen that. That is cool. The Boba Fett cartoon, that cartoon segment kind of makes me think of like it's got that same drugged out vibe that the Star Trek animated series has. Damn it, I said the T word. I shouldn't say the T word on May the 4th. I'm in trouble now. Okay, hold up. Ooh, shit. I swear to God. Okay. Got a corner fight. Seem to remember there not being anything of interest down here. I remember correctly. Cool. Wish I could have remembered that before I wasted a few seconds of time. Die, interrogation droid. Let the blaster recharge. Oh, shit! I keep forgetting that, like, the blaster is not counting your actual shots. It's, like, a percentage. So it's like I have... Every shot is 20... 20%... of your laser. And I do get the impression laser is probably a misnomer, but whatever. I've never been really too clear on that. Well, no, I guess, no. It should be pretty clear. Whatever. Han Solo calls them laser blasts. Shut up, Tim. Of course, then again, Han Solo might just be, like, you know, speaking informally. I don't know. Who cares? I do. That's why I'm obsessing over this. From what I can infer... It might not be a literal laser, but it also doesn't matter that it's not a literal laser. Because the point is, Han Solo meant weapon. That wasn't a shot fired at us. Is the gist of what he's trying to say. So my obsessing over whether or not he literally meant laser means that I'm not seeing the forest through the trees on that remark. Oh, come on, you fucking piece of shit! I'll kill you with my laser! Shit. Okay. There we go. Ooh. Okay, I gotta do something about my energy level here. Pardon me a sec. Not better. All right. Die, please. Come on, fucker. There we go. Ah, shit. Wiped out. Yet again. No, I'm going this way. Sorry. Is it dead? It is. And then there's that. Oh, no! That is obnoxious. That is fucking obnoxious. Just float, Tim. Just fucking float across. Whatever. You motherfucker! Jesus. Alright, there we go. God! Got the disruptor, gonna spank this guy. That's the fun part. Okay, cool. Fuck! I'm tired of your shit, Shadows. Alright. Fuck. Kill everyone over here. Okay. Okay, got the pulse cannon. Now let's get the fuck out of here. See, already I feel like I'm kind of close to where I was. Just don't fuck up and die. We got the tower coming up, don't we? Yeah, we do. Yep, you gotta go. Oh, shit. Jeez. What? You don't even know they're there till they're shooting you. Oh, I see you. Nope. All right. Thank you, that was a death. Good lord. Ooh. Yeah, that's... Oh no! Fuck. I'm doing worse than before now. I'm already down to zero lives. Shit. Fuck. Is anyone up here? No one at the moment. Okay. Gonna get that. Please fucking die! God damn it! Why aren't you dead? Solid reason, anyone. Please be dead. Please be dead. Please be dead. Thank you. fucking tension is killing me. Oh no! Oh no, that's just steam. My connection's fine. What the hell's going on here? Why is it all these programs that I close at the beginning of my session reopen? Like, I don't want you in my system tray right now. Stop it. I'm busy. Especially you, fucking, especially you, Steam. Okay, we're good. Huh. Oh shit, hold on. Got dark again, didn't it? Yeah. Flip that switch. The pulse bombs are set. Yeah, that's great. That's wonderful. There was a challenge point up here somewhere. Where was it? There it is. I'll take it. I just don't want to die again. I'll bet I will. Oh no. What's the way out of this room? Nope. Die, 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 die. Well, this room has health in it, at least. Oh, God. Now, here comes the tricky part. Living long enough. Yep, here we go. Here's hoping I don't screw this one up. But I am gonna circle strafe this guy to death again. That just seems to be the best way to go. I really hope that there's health back there. Come on. Oh no, that door fucking closes. That door closes. Hope you weren't trying to find any advantages in there. Yeah. Is he lost? Come on, buddy. It is a pretty awesome looking robot design, though. It looks flashy and expensive. Oh shit. You. I'll get ya. I'll get you, you son of a gun. Whoa, shit. Damn you. Come on. Okay. Chris, what's up? Hey, it's all right, man. It's all good. I actually had to, I had to quit in order to go to work, and then work got canceled, so it all worked out. Or... No! Uh-uh. No! God fucking damn it. I'm getting tired of getting game overs on this level. Alright. Let's try that again. This is my third fucking, like, complete level restart on Shizor's Palace today. Oh, I work at a restaurant. I work at a restaurant. We have an outdoor dining section. And we had to close it today because of thunderstorms. So I got sent home. We, probably could have sent me home earlier, like before I even had to get out there. But, they had just installed a new system, of portable handsets so that people can take orders at their tables. Just to make it easier to keep serving outdoors. And so I think that they were still... I think they were still working out the bugs in that system, so they had to... That had the manager's focus. So I get that. I live real close by, so I don't really mind... getting there and then having to leave shortly after. Woo! I don't really get too bent out of shape out of that. Bent too far out of shape over that kind of thing. If I lived further away, I might have been pissed, but, like, I don't know. Seemed like they had other things going on, and they can't pay full attention to what everybody on staff needs all the time, and my god, they have a track record of trying their best, so I'm not really complaining. I like where I work. Damn! That's your May sorted, nice. Resident Evil Village looks fucking awesome. I'm probably not gonna play it at launch. Shit. Yeah. I'm probably not gonna play it at launch. Damn. But, that's because I have not played 7 yet. I'm behind. Ooh, there we go. But I like that Village is, like, following the template of 7 and doing really cool stuff. Nearly shit yourself a few times. I hear ya. Oh, shit. Okay, fuck. I need a door fight a little more often. And stop relying on the presence of health. Ooh, shit! Is it dead? It is dead. These silver robots kind of suck at their jobs. I feel bad for them. They exist just to get completely destroyed by me. I mean, look at that shit. Poor guy. Oh, never mind. They fire guns. Fuck that. Yeah, you keep turning slowly, buddy. You can sell it on eBay again like Spider-Man Miles Morales. That's fair. Ooh. I like getting things physically just because I'm paranoid about my digital collection just, like, failing one day. Like, maybe the storefront I buy it from disappears at a time when I happen to not have everything downloaded. Or the console that I have things downloaded on bricks. That's why I baby my PS3. That system has served me very well, but, like, it's also old. They're not gonna support it for much longer, really. I know the store is not gonna vanish, but, like, let's be real. The state of support for the PS3 is about to get skeletal. Did I just kill a Red Ranger? It did kind of look like that, didn't it, Scott? Did I check if there's an alternative fire mode yet? Yeah, I did check. Turns out there isn't. Although, you know, now that you mention it, I think maybe the fact that this game doesn't have alternative fire modes might be why I didn't check when playing Dark Forces. And I feel very silly about that because I knew about the alternate fire modes in Dark Forces 2. Yeah, hey. And I just didn't bother checking in the first game, so... I'm just a silly dope who doesn't really have a sense for continuity or precedent. You motherfucker! See, that's where I need to go. When I get to that room, I will check underneath for stuff. Physical collection for the 360 and PS3 is precious, but your PS4 is all digital, and you really don't care about it at all. That's, you know, that's fair. Most of my PS4 collection has actually come from PlayStation Plus. And I just, you know, I feel like that's been a good value overall. And I have, you know, importantly, I actually play the games that I get from PlayStation Plus. And they are usually things that I wouldn't have tried otherwise, so... Hello, what the fuck? Oh my. What a wonderful room. Okay. Thanks. What's in here? A window big enough for me to fly into that I'm not allowed to fly into for video game reasons. Last time you tried to buy physical, Amazon lost the delivery twice. That fucking sucks. I've noticed that if I can avoid UPS delivery, I will. Because, I shit you not, every single time this past year that a delivery has been been sent here, whether I've ordered it or Holly has ordered it, if UPS is the carrier, it has gotten lost. Enjoying Horizon Zero Dawn for free. Yeah, I jumped on that. And I also got Days Gone. Zombie Army. I'm excited about all of them, but particularly Zombie Army, just because I am a big fan of Sniper Elite V2. I should stream that one of these days. Because I love Sniper Elite. It's just a fucking, like, good-ass, violent-ass, game. Needlessly gory. Just the way I like it. But there's a lot of stealth and deception in Sniper Elite. And that's what really You know, it's the fact that the game is kind of devious. And I really dig that. Oh no, that's okay. I very specifically avoid help with that kind of stuff. But I think I would really enjoy that game. Let's see. Violent ass, yeah. Here we go. Okay, I need to make sure not to fucking fly. Or, sorry, not to jump. I should fly through these, because every time I've jumped, I get hurt. Okay, it's dead. I will wait. Take me through. Yay! Good. Alright, I didn't fucking die. Good. Christ. Got the platinum trophy in Horizon Zero Dawn. Holy shit, that's awesome. I checked. I don't have a single platinum trophy on PSN. Not one. Added a new difficulty. Damn, okay. You stop! Breathing! Good one. Oh yeah, I gotta kill this guy. You're dead. Let's get the pulse cannon ammo. Now this fucking room. Okay, yeah, let's go. Got distracted by doing another New Vegas playthrough. That's totally fair. You playing on PC, console? How you playing New Vegas? Shit, that fucking sucked. You! Motherfucker! Get out! Yeah! It's what you get! I like when they scream all the way down. Makes me smile for reasons that my mother finds disturbing. Let's see. Oh, okay. I'll take that. No, hey! You get the gun. All right. I don't think there's any secrets to be had down here, so let's fly. I did get everything down here, yeah? I guess. Oh, God. PC, okay. Not a single platinum. I mean, it's just how it... That's just how it is. It's not like I've never completed a PS3 game, but it's that, like, I don't know, just... Chasing platinums has never really been something I've done. I have a lot of achievements on Xbox 360. I'm really weird when it comes to achievement hunting, though. For instance, I have every single achievement you could possibly get in Duke Nukem Forever. Platinum in this economy. I have every achievement you can get on Xbox Live in Duke Nukem Forever. Including the DLCs. So my gamer score in Duke Nukem Forever is like over 1,200. It's silly. Ten platinum trophies and the last one was Days Gone. That's awesome. The old Fallout games, but you can't play them. Are you talking about like the top-down ones? Because, I mean, to be honest, I understand that. I do enjoy playing, top-down, like, action-adventure and role-playing games. Although I do usually get role-playing game burnout. Like, I get role-playing game burnout fast. Because I have a goldfish brain. That's what I'm looking for. Pulse bombs are planted. That's cool. Now, where do I go? Do I go here? Fuck no. I can usually commit long enough to a strategy game to finish it, but I also rarely ever play new strategy games. The last time I sat down and did a full playthrough of a strategy game was when I reinstalled Freedom Force. You're the opposite. You platinum hunt and you're on your Xbox. Last one you got all the achievements was Minecraft Season 2 in 2017. Okay. Lord Sathian, no, I have not played Wasteland 2. Although we were just talking about old Fallout games, so that's an interesting jumping on point. Because Wasteland 2... I mean, Fallout was based on Wasteland. It was originally going to be a sequel to it, and then that just didn't happen. So it's... How is that? Shit! You fucking piece of... Okay. Don't get mad. Just kill them. North 3 or Vegas, you find them boring. That's fair. How do you feel about Diablo? Because Diablo is pretty fast-paced. Because, like, not getting into top-down games is... Or, sorry, a top-down perspective has never been, like, a barrier for me. But it is one of those things where, like, when people aren't into it, I do kind of understand. It's one of those things that I don't share, but I get. Okay. 3 lives! I'm coming for you, fucking... Gladiator. And this time I got 3 fucking lives. Try to take all of them, he said, before losing. Alright. Here we go. I'm not even gonna fucking honor you with using another weapon. I am just gonna keep pistoling you, and then I am unloading disruptors into your fucking face. Okay. So, Chris Massey, I know that you've said that you don't like top-down games, and I get that. If you get a chance, and if it's ever cheap, or if you can, like, literally borrow a friend's disc, maybe check out Diablo 2. Like, I don't want to encourage you to spend money on it, specifically because you just said that these kinds of games really tend to not work with you. But I'm curious, because Diablo 2 is so fast-paced, I'd be curious to know if Diablo 2 is a game that you wind up enjoying. But at the same time, maybe a better thing to do is check out the original version of StarCraft. Check out its campaign. Because that is free. That's probably better advice. Alright. Let's hit him with them disruptors. Fuck! BFG time, asshole! Am I dead? Yeah, don't care. Fuck you. Die, motherfucker! Suck it, gladiator! Life well spent! Jurassic Park on the SNES when you were a kid, that was your jam. Okay, okay. Oh, what the fuck? How are you? Oh. How many times do I have to kill your fucking ass? What? Okay, what the fuck is going on? Yeah, fuck! Okay. I gotta be careful or I'm gonna fucking die again. I did die again! Oh my god. Fuck you! Oh my god, okay. Okay. I gotta not play this like an idiot. Shit. You fucking asshole! You can climb all the way over this fucking level. It's gonna make me restart. I know it is. I can fucking feel it. I can fucking feel it. I got complacent because I thought that this was only a two-stage fight. I was mistaken. And I'm paying for that mistake now. Where are you? Nope, fuck you. And you're homing in on bullshit. Fucking crap. Can you do something constructive, homing missile? No, because you're a homing missile. Your purpose is not construction. Fuck you. Why? The jetpack has limited fuel. Fuck this. Oh, God. No! No, 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 no. Oh, God. Oh, no, 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 no. Shit. God fucking damn it. That was entirely my fault. Because I just acted like there was gonna be a cutscene. So I have to do all that fucking shit again, because I'm a dumbass. Shit. This whole fucking motherfucking thing. After all that shit I was talking. Three lives! I got three lives. Come and take them, he says, before he dies. And then that fucking bites me in the ass. Fuck you. Get all the fucking Power Rangers on the way here. Get out of my fucking way. You red faction looking ass goon. Fuck you. And you. And you. What? Stop fucking bothering me. Asshole. Diablo 2 is only on PC, yes. Diablo 3 is on consoles. I've never played Diablo 3. But me saying, I've heard it's good, is not the same as me saying, oh, this is good. I can't really vouch for it the same way. Ugh. Fucking pissed. Fall down. Your mother was a Game Boy. Fuck you. Out of my way. Jesus. Instantly get shot. There's like nothing you can do to avoid it. That's the game, though. You bastard. Get the fuck out of my way. Fall down. You too. Anything over here? Nope. There is always nothing over there. I check every time I play. Ooh. Never owned a PC. Okay. Oh, my mistake. Okay. Oh, there's a remaster coming to consoles. That's fucking awesome. My hands are disgusting right now. Jesus Christ. Seriously syrupy. Mm-hmm. Kill ya. Die, please. Thank you. All right. I'll take this. That was 30. Good. You gotta die. You did die. Woo! Shit! I hate that fucking shit. There we go. Let's go upstairs. Can't even avoid it! This is bullshit. What? Okay. My God, why? Yeah, I'll take that. Okay, and then there's this way. Come on, let me around the corner, please. Kill him! Make him dead. I already wish he was never born. I just need to convince him to agree. Okay. God! We're good. Anything else here new? Time to kill. Fuck! Ridiculous, man. Just ridiculous. Absolutely nothing that could be done to prevent that. Hold on. That looks like it goes awful high. Hello. Did I? Okay. Let me flip a switch here and see if that opens up something higher up. It does. And I have another disruptor out of it. Okay. So far, so good. Fuck you. Alright. Let's kill these guys. There's no recoil. This is just actually the shake is coming from, my thumb hitting the button is shaking my other thumb on the controller. You can't just, like, let go while you're aiming. You do that and it returns to the center position. Whew. That was very common back in the day. Games don't really do that anymore. They make aiming guns easy. Which, like, I get. Like, the last game I can think of that had a control scheme where you had to hold the joystick at a certain level of pressure in order to aim your shots was, like, Time Splitters 2. It's been a long fucking time. Because that game came out in, like, what, 2002? Maybe 2003, but probably 2002. Alright, let's go down here. Now let's try not to die when I get to this next room, which is a big pain in the ass, and I'm getting tired of clearing it out. But okay, here we go. Ooh! Awesome. Okay. Fuck. Damn. Where was that? It was you! You little bastard. Alright. I don't think he died. No, he did not die. He ain't dead. I don't trust it. Okay, maybe he is dead. He's acting kind of dead at this point. I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. All right. Okay. Sorry about that, folks. Looks like the internet connection kind of shit the bed for a second, but it's back. Not much changed. I just killed a couple dudes. Fuck. Oh, somebody shot me from up there. Or tried to. Oh no, no one did. I was seeing this floating challenge marker. That's what it was. Oh, you gotta go. He's dead. He's very, very dead. Yes, I know, pulse bombs and all that. And where do I go? I always have a little bit of trouble finding the door out of here. I think that's it. Yeah, that's it. Whoa, oh, whoa, 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 hey! Come on, Tim. What the hell, man? Shit! Alright. Take that. Get that. What else is in here? Anything? No. Just fucking death. Alright. I'm good on death. With four disruptors, I'd say I'm very good on death. I think I would be well served. One, take this guy out the same as normal. But then when I do that, I need to clear the arena of other enemies. Because this guy just becomes more of a pain in the ass with each physical form he takes. And actually, if I can take out his floating upper torso form with just missiles, then I can save my four disruptor blasts for when he's just ahead. That's probably the way to do this. I just gotta die as few times as possible in order to make this work. Ooh. Come on. Hold up. Let's make this a little brighter. That's better. Oh, what the fuck? Hold on. Sorry. Oh yeah, that'll work. Okay. Good. Can't really see where I am, but that's fine. Let's kill this guy this way. My lighting solution. Dragging around windows on my second monitor. Just open File Explorer and shove it in the corner of the screen. That's some white light for you. Come on. Four, three, two, one, zero, 19, 18, 17, 16, fuck. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 1. Okay, that's one form down. Now, give me Heat Seekers. Okay, pulse rounds work too, I guess. Fuck. Duck. Ah, shit. Fuck. Okay. Shit, 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 shit. Those are Heat Seekers. I'm in trouble. Dude! How the hell did those last shots not hit him? Okay, this is bullshit. Hundred percent, those shots should have hurt him. Fuck. Okay, gladiator form is dead. Now I just gotta blow his fucking head off. Jetpack malfunction, fuck you! Oh, get closer, you son of a bitch. Oh. 77. Aw, what's the matter? Oh god, okay. Am I dead? One disruptor left. Come on, fucker. No! No! Don't you dare fucking kill me, you son of a bitch! What the fuck?! Dude! What?! I hate this fight. This game is wasting my fucking time. All right. Fuck, right off. Hey! I don't even want to know you. I just want you to be a smear. A smear on the walls of this shitty place. You should have stayed a smear on the bedsheet, fuck you. Let's hold off there. I'll take this. I thought for sure I had him. I had those disruptor rounds, I was kicking his ass. Got him to under 10 health. But nope. It's that fucking laser. And what bothers me about that laser is that, like, it will hit you even when it clearly is missing you. It still hits you. If he's just facing your general direction, you will take the damage. Game is lies and bullshit. Alright, it's fine. Use the force. Use the force. Make the coffee. Oh, fuck. Maybe more cover and patience before charging in. Yeah, I think that is what it's going to have to take. Oh, shit. I mean, definitely pistol him to death the first time, because that's like a zero risk move. I get to save all my other stuff. What bothered me was, like, there was one volley of the pulse cannon that I fired at him that looked like it was connecting, but it turns out it was dealing no damage. And I'm wondering what the hell that was about. I also think I need to play this level a little more carefully. Because any damage I take going into that fight is going to bite me in the ass later. I need to hold on to that first life for dear life. Because I get disoriented when I respawn. So I want to avoid that happening. Die! I didn't check that direction this time. I'm making coffee. Whoa. Oh. Hold on. Now again, Tim, don't burn your hands or your legs. Don't do it. I don't advise it. Ahem. Whoa. Okay, very cool. Shit, 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 shit. Good. That worked. Where's my spoon? There it is. Coffee time. Ah! We can do this. We can absolutely do this. Damn! That was a little careless. There we go. I thought he was green. I guess he's not. I guess he's just the color of whatever shading they're using for distance fog. Alright. Or only explode where it hits. Can you run under him in the final form? The disruptor does not only work in close range, but it works better at close range. I'm hoping to score a direct hit. So I think a direct hit will take like an even 25%, but I'm not sure. I mean, it's a powerful shot. It's basically like the BFG from fucking Doom, but like, it's hard to hit him directly with it. And running under him gets really tricky because of the maze. And he can fly, like, right over the walls. But I can't, because my jetpack malfunctions after the second form. So at a certain point, At a certain point, I am stuck. Oh, shit. Of course. At a certain point, I am stuck fighting him on foot. Die! Get up! Move! Thank you. So I gotta make sure that I, yeah, I'm just maining the pistol. There we go. That stage is complete. I think what I really need to do is that second form. That second form, I need to, like, live for as long as I can and also clear the room out. Get rid of as many of his little robot friends as I can. Okay, got the challenge point, got the disruptor. Woo! You know what? That's fine. That's fine. I missed one. I don't care. No skin off my back. Looks like I'm still killing them. Yeah. Okay. Oh, ouch. Oh, wow, I didn't think that that would actually, work. Neat. Well, that's an awful slow-moving gear. I mean, I know that, I know that will hurt me if it touches me, but... No, I'm not gonna go that way. That seems like suicide. Had enough of that today. Die, please! There we go. Things get desperate. There we go. But! I accidentally activated my jetpack. Whoops! Okay. All right. Whoa! Shit! Forgot about him. All right. I wonder. Nope. Didn't think so. It was worth checking out, though. Alright. Open it. When do I get to that really vertical room that's right here? Neat. Aha! Of course I'm taking damage. Why wouldn't I be? Taking damage is the Jedi way. But I'm not a Jedi. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Where are ya? Damn it. Oh, God. Okay, that's a death. Anybody else up here? No. All right, cool. And let's get the switch. Good job getting that switch, Tim. All right. Oh, God! Really? Of course. Of fucking course. Great. Little tension to wake me up. That's what I need. I just need to be scared shitless the entire time I play this game. Ah, damn it. Did I get that switch? Yeah. And okay, this is where I go. Open the fucking door. Alright. I always forget there is no health down there. None. Zilch. Not a zero. So don't go down there looking for health. Upper level. There might be health up top. Yeah, I'll go take a look. Nope. Backtrack? Anything? I'm just trying to scrape up, like, a point of health from somewhere. Fuck you. I know how this is gonna go. I'm gonna backtrack, but it's gonna take me through rings. Or something. It's gonna take me here. Fuck. Okay. I'm gonna lose more health in this endeavor than I gain. I'm not saying I'm calling that, but it's a guess. I have a feeling that this is not gonna be a profitable gambit. Nothing, see? That's as far back as it takes me. Cool. That's great. How do I get that challenge point? That's probably from the slow wheel. That's probably where that's from. Let's see, what have you got to lose? Oh! Oh my god! Hey! Alright, not the worst instincts there, Tim. Gotta run? Okay, man, I'll see you around. Thank you for spending as much time here as you did. I hope you enjoyed yourself. I certainly did. I like shooting the shit and talking Star Wars while shooting shit. Oh no. Uh-oh. Huh. Oh. Whoa! Crap. Crap. Crap, crap, crap. Yep, this is bad. And I'm dead. Good thing I got that full health. Why do I try? I just thoroughly fucked up my chances. Insult to injury. In the form of another injury. Listen while you played Resident Evil. Awesome. You have a good one. Oh. God, Village looks good. Ooh. I'm pretty sure that Jordan is going to be playing that in VR. He has been all about VR Okay. Really? He never hits me first. That's crazy. Alright, alright. This is just meme-worthy now. Alright. Open it. Do have the full health. That's cool. Okay. We got a challenge point of full health. That's really not worth it. Fuck. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Alright. Laser. I'll bet the stunner does not freeze the boss. Give it a try. Hit the boss with the stunner, see what happens. Might as well experiment. What do you gotta lose? Your life? Yes, I know. You're big and scary, and I'm psyched out. Yeah, the stunner is not working here. Can I open this? No. I hate his stupid fucking head. He just gets more dangerous with every part of his body he loses. How does that work? Oh, God. Yeah, so I'm thinking after, like Carl was saying, it's after the first life, I need to really focus on taking cover. I know that the pulse cannon works against him. It's effective against, you know, floating torso form. It seems like the missiles are really unreliable against this guy, so I can save the missiles for, like, the little labyrinth-dwelling fucks. Oh! Nope, hold still. Okay, here he goes. Pulse cannon. Use the pulse cannon. Oh god. Nope. Yeah, see, that's what I gotta avoid. That's what I have to avoid. That is dangerous. I hate that attack. I hate it quite a lot. Doesn't hit him! Oh, it's the range! His limited fucking range. Okay, I get it. Oh, fuck you, man. Ooh! Yeah, see, that does it. Shit! Stop it. He had a flamethrower, that's bad. Get him. Try and take out the torso without using your lasers. Or without using your disruptor. Come on. Alright, nope, got a bit of a rhythm, but this rhythm's gonna get fucked once. Oh, shit. God. No! Piss off! Oh, God. Okay, 55. 55. Oh, come on! That sucked. Come on. Get... This is stressful. One life. One life. Come on. Where is he? There he is. Nope. God damn. No! Jesus! That attack is scarier than it... It looks scarier than it is, I think. Yeah, so far so good. Don't jinx it, Timothy. Oh god, oh god. Out of the way. Fuck. I don't like it when he starts using his flamethrower and shit. Fuck! Yep, see? Took a hit on that one. Wasn't good. Shit, run! Okay, how much more can you take? So I think I want to get... No, come on, Tim. I want to try to get back on the center column. Fuck. Yeah. Damn. Oh, I hate that fucking attack. It's so cheap. Shit. Okay. Damn. Disruptor time. Oh, God. Oh, see, now that's what it is. It's limited now. That's what it is. Where is it? Where is he? There you are. I see you. Oh, you... You're kidding me. Oh my god, what? No. There's no way I'm out of fucking ammo. That's horse shit. I should have waited. I used my disruptor shots all at once. That was fucking stupid. Come on, you fuck stick. I hate you. Fuck you, Gladiator! Fuck you, you piece of shit! I hate you! I never want to see you again until the next time I play this game. Get fucked! God damn! Yeah. More cover. More cover was the move. So, 100% right there. You were 100% right there. Woo! Oh my god. Looks like we're on a skyhook now. She's always headed for... Oh god, I can't even speak anymore. Keep us on course while I take out the guns and blast the fighters into space dust. Thank you very much. Ah, oh, let's go. Gotta fight off the fighters. I'm gonna go into first person here. Let's get them. Shit. Yeah, his fighters are dangerous as fuck. Damn, ow, what the fuck? Alright. Shit. Where is the incoming bomb? Oh my god. So many! Jesus! Damn! What the fuck just happened to me? Ow! Yeah, I see the bomb! Alright. Shit. Oh! Okay, good! Yes, I needed that bonus life, as it turned out. Shit. Cool, how many are left? Please? Please don't be too many, this is nuts. Oh, crap. Ooh, come on! Yes! Ooh, okay. Got him. Yeah! Unintelligible noises. Fuck. God damn. I don't know where the bombs are. I keep getting bonus lives as soon as I'm losing them. Whatever score these things are worth, it must be a ton. Jeez! They use the fucking asteroid feel of music so well here. This is just like Arcadian sanity. Yes! Fuck. Ah! Oh! Fucking sweaty palms right now. Yep, there's another. Bet I'm gonna die. Yup! Huh? How many more I got? 61 fighters destroyed! Jeez! How many's it gotta be? Stop! I can't see shit. Oh, fuck. Nope. We got Star Destroyers now, huh? Come on. Fucking fancy pants Cheezor with his expensive ass fleet. Jeez! Oh, god! More like Prince Seizure. Okay. I am maintaining. Oh, god. Just kill enough, you'll be fine, Tim. Just get into a nice murder frenzy. And you can manage. Oh. Yes. Holy shit! Yep, looks like I made it. Or at least I made it this far. Oh, sweating like a pig. I am so foul right now. Okay. Alright. Turret range. Yes, I see it. Damn it! Shit! That was bad. Okay. This is an awesome, climactic, just apocalyptic sounding track. And I died. That was dumb. But what's worse is I didn't take the fucking gun out with me. That's the real problem. That's my actual regret. Move! What? Does that motherfucker recharge? Okay, there we fucking go. God damn! Didn't realize it would recharge. Fuck! Damn. Damn it! How many lives I got? Probably not many. I can't afford to do that again. It looks like I killed it, though. 5 missiles, that's good. Enough to feel comfortable on a strafe run. Ah, fuck. Fuck. Alright, turret destroyed. Jesus fucking Christ. Beautiful. This is so awesome. We got fucking Rebel ships, we got fucking Imperial ships. Not exactly happy to see each other, but they're not trying to kill each other exactly. They got bigger fish to fry, and that is this prick. Fuck. Ah! Nope, turret's alive. Fuck. Shit. Yep, that's what I needed. I'm worried, though, about, I'm worried about whether or not I'm gonna live long enough for any of this to matter. Shit. Where is Skyhook? Where's the turret? There it is, I see it. Run! What? I missed? Okay, no, I didn't miss. Good. That does it for the turrets. Now fly inside and destroy the core. Alright. I'm down. Sounds like a suicide mission. Better find someone who needs to fake their own death. Who's up for the job? Dash Rendar's like, this is my time to shine. Alright. Oh, fuck. What the fuck? Fucking excuse me? Oh, shit, no, don't you dare. Alright, we got this. We got this. Come on. Okay. Yes. Why is that not working? I'm confused. Is it that I have to, like, lock on or something? Oh, God. Okay. What? Sure. All right. What's up, St. Petersburg? I'm right at the end level of Star Wars Shadows of the Empire. Trying to make it through and not fail. I don't think I have many lives left. So I gotta be careful here. Do I have to approach from a certain angle? Like, what the fuck? I know I don't have room to turn around. Oh, in St. Petersburg. May the 4th be with you. Ooh, here we go. Okay, well that hit it. Finally worked that time. Okay. Odd. Oh, good fucking job, Tim. You almost killed yourself. What platform? I'm playing this on an N64. Ah, good, I got more missiles. That's good. Oh, shit. Ooh, okay, yeah, I'm playing this on a Nintendo 64. This game is available on PC, but I'm more comfortable playing this on an N64. Ooh. Okay. All right, reactor core is down to 50%. Oh, let's go. All right. Stop it, Tim. Holy shit. Okay, that's where I'm going. Getting a touch disoriented! Whoa! Yeesh! That scared the shit out of me. Alright. ...25%. This is gonna be sick. Sounds like a true film score. Yes. It really does. This game's soundtrack is fucking exceptional. And it's not a MIDI soundtrack, which is interesting, you know, in and of itself. The fact that the N64 version of this game has, that this version of the game on an N64, at launch, even, had this kind of a soundtrack. But this feels huge and epic and Star Wars and... I love it. Shit. And the sense of scale of this battle is just... They knocked this out of the park. Hit it! All right. Get the fuck out of there. Go. Get out, get out, get out, get out, get out, get out! Yes! I've never actually beaten Force Unleashed. I've started it a few times. And, I do like it. Every time I've started Force Unleashed, I think, man, I really want to play Jedi Knight 2 now. So then I do. It's a bad habit. Huh. I can't believe Dash didn't make it out of that explosion, Leia. He was such a great pilot. I know, Luke, but he didn't die in vain. Thanks to him, the Alliance no longer has anything to fear from Black Sun, and the Imperial computer he captured is being decoded right now. It may well contain information worth the price Dash paid with his life. But I'm pretty sure that Dash Rendar isn't actually dead. In fact, I think that that's what I'm about to find out here. Yes! Yeah, there we go! Lebo, we've made some great disappearances, but that was one for the books. Captain, I don't understand. Why don't you want the others to know we survived? First of all, we weren't hired for that stunt back there, so there's no point waiting around for a reward. Second, Shizor's already sent every thug in the galaxy after us. But if everyone thinks we're dead, who's gonna be looking? Besides, it's nice to be remembered as a martyr and still be alive, right? That's, kind of dark, but awesome. Hold on, let me... Yeah, there we go. Oh, that Dash Rendar. The warp tunnel looks really good. Or the light speed tunnel effect. Congratulations! Now try finishing the game on hard. Oh, that was fun. That was absolutely tons of fun. Buckets, oodles of noodles. Ah. It is hot in here. Holy shit. Yeah, throwing people around using force abilities is fun. What I remember being really cool was, like, just, like, how it wasn't just enemies, it was, like, objects in the environment as well. Like, the force was a way to manipulate the physics in the game. And that was really neat. Ah. So in a weird way, the Force Unleashed always made me think of, there was this game, PsyOps the Mindgate Conspiracy. It was like a third-person shooter where you had telekinetic abilities. It wasn't really a hack-and-slash angle to it, but there was a lot of, never actively tried to sabotage the project was Tim Schafer. That's funny. But PsyOps was one of those games where you could use your mind and you could lift people off the ground and throw them, like, at each other, and it was very, very similar in a lot of ways. Without getting frustrated playing yourself. Well, thank you. I'm glad you enjoyed yourself. I did, too. I'm glad that I didn't start... I contemplated starting today on hard mode. I'm glad I didn't do that. I might do that at a later date, but, like, it's hot as fuck in this apartment. My hands are disgusting. My controller is now disgusting. I need to clean it. Hey, you're welcome. You're welcome. That's a hell of a lot of fun. I like to think that this game chose me, though. Like, this was... I don't think this was the first Star Wars game I ever saw or played. I think that might have been, like... X-Wing. But, like, this game made me want an N64. Like, when I saw this game when I was 7, this was the coolest fucking thing I'd ever seen. And, when I got an N64, the first two games I got were Star Fox 64 and Shadows of the Empire. Got those, like, the same day. And, you know, I have always loved this game. I used to draw Dash Rendar. Like, I was kind of obsessed with the character. Had a man crush, definitely. Definitely had a man crush on Dash Rendar. I mean, how could you not with a name like that? Dark Horse Comics. The horse has gone to the dark side. Can I beat those times? Probably not. Shizor's Palace in 6.5 minutes? God. That's insane. I can kind of understand Battle of Hoth in like 3:06, but the rest just seems insane. Oh, wait, are the credits looping now? I think they are. Aesthetic technology and Robin's dad. Yeah, these are looping. These are looping because we definitely passed level designers already. Literally bought the N64 solely because of this game. Yeah, that's fair. That's fair. Oh, man. I also really liked, Rogue Squadron. But Rogue Squadron I've never beaten because I'm not quite so good at, like, flying games. Like, Star Fox, yeah, but Star Fox is very arcadey. Rogue Squadron is more arcadey than your average simulator, but it's, Rogue Squadron is very strict and very difficult. And, I tend to only get certain... What, Greg Land, like the comic book artist? I doubt it. In New Carrollton to get your system because they were selling out everywhere. That makes sense. Oh yeah, we're looping. We're into looping credits now. Oh man, that was fun. Should I pop in Rogue Squadron? What should I do here? Might do it for a minute. I kind of feel like it's my duty to. Oh shit, let me drop everything. Yeah. Get like a level of Rogue Squadron out of the way. Because Rogue Squadron is one of those games. It's one of those N64 games that's just like, how did something this pretty get made for this system? I still find the terrain kind of impressive, honestly. How are we doing here? We're doing all right. God, is that Toys R Us still around? I feel like I remember that place. That's a hell of a logo. That's just cool as shit. Oh. My God, would you look at the resolution on that JPEG? Whoa! This is technical wizardry. How did they do this? I will always be stunned.
The cowardly Imperial governor is looting the city, using his weapons.
I mean, that's... Even this menu screen looks legit as fuck. Affectionate Corellia, the search for Nona. I'll try the level I'm stuck on. Liberation of Gerard V.
Governor is looting the city, using his luxury yachts to transport stolen...
Here we go. I'll go with this until I fail it. Which is probably not gonna take long, because I'm not good at Rogue Squadron. And the sprites are like little Command and Conquer looking dudes.
Gerard V is attempting to gain its independence, but the Imperial Governor is looting the city. Rogue Squadron, you must protect Krix Maydeen's Y-Wings while they disable the escaping ship. Don't worry.
I feel like all these Star Wars games at some point have me protecting or rescuing Krix Maydeen. In the movie, he's barely there. In the games, he's... You gotta rescue him all the time. Alright. Oh shit. Oh crap, okay. Fuck, there we go. Jesus.
The good work.
That went way better than I thought it would. Oh, fuck. Okay. Is that an enemy? That's an enemy. It's gotta go.
Help me out here. Rear shield scout.
Working on it.
Help me out here. Nice shot. Rear shield's down.
Shields on what? What's out there? I don't see anybody. Oh. I see this asshole. Woo!
Rogue Squadron, where's our cover? We've got to destroy the
missile
turret. Trying
to find you, buddy.
Y-wings are done for.
I'm clear, but my factor's down.
Where is the missile turret, damn it?
We've got to destroy those missile turrets. Otherwise, the Y-wings are done for.
Oh, there's one.
I'm clear, but my
got it.
Is down.
Shit! Let's go! Fuck! Speaking of the frustration after playing some old games, honestly, you quite forgot how frustrating old games can be. Beat Driver 2 on medium this week, and that was painful. I really like Driver 2, but I understand what you mean. They're both hard. The first game is more annoying to me just because there's that fucking tutorial that basically just, like, locks you off from the rest of the game until you beat it. And that tutorial is itself insanely hard. Like, that tutorial to me in Driver 1 is the hardest part of the game. And it's just asinine.
Remember, let the Y-Wings take care of the yachts. Rogue Squadron flies cover.
You know what's surprisingly good is the GBA version of Driver 2. Oh, crap. Shit! Okay. Like, after playing, because the first version of Doom I ever played was actually the Game Boy Advance version, so I got kind of obsessed with seeing what other 3D games there were on the GBA. And Driver 2 on the GBA is fucking underrated as shit.
Rogue Squadron, where's our cover?
We've got to destroy those missile turrets. Otherwise, the Y-Wings are done for.
Working on the missile turret, sir.
I'm clear, but my fighter is down. Help me out, yeah. Rear shield
Who the hell?
Help me out here. Rear shield's down.
Who the hell fired that shot? Oh, it's this fucker. Damn it. Did I change firing modes? Why the fuck would I do that? That's better. Get him. Shit. Damn. Okay. Wedge!
It's 128 high intercepted quadrant. Now the back. Cut the chassis. Wedge, pull them off as best you can. Rogue, we're gonna have company real soon.
Fucking love Wedge. I was so happy with his cameo in fucking Rise of Skywalker. Oh, okay, okay. I think that is the movie I want to watch tonight.
Thanks, Rogue Group. I'm clear.
Rise of Skywalker just sounds nice. Just because the movie feels like a celebration of Star Wars. And I am absolutely up for that. Okay, I need to go first person. Fly! Don't get hurt! Ah, shit. Alright. Oh, that was awkward. But I'm alive. Rest in peace, frame rate. I see, that's what that does. So, how do I fucking move faster?
I have fire. The S-foils are closed.
What? Oh! That's actually how. The hell is down there? Oh! It's right there. It's the brakes. Okay. Z is the brakes. Come on, Tim. Oh, it's such a beautiful ship. Fuck. Where the hell is my target? I feel like I'm going insane. I don't even see a target. Woo-hoo-hoo. I think I'm just supposed to go this way. You're out of here, Carl. I will see you around. It's always a pleasure. And I hope you have a nice day too. Oh god.
Disable the civilian yachts.
The game is talking to me. Come on, game. I'm trying to take a break. I'll see you around, man. You have a good one. And thanks for spending time here. Always glad to have you. When you try again and again for 50 or 100 or... Yes! No, that is very forgotten. In fact, that's usually like a point of criticism at this point. And to an extent, I think it should be. But on the other hand, you know, it pays to, like, learn a game by trying over and over again. Damn. As if to make my point, I just got a game over. So, oops. Anyway, I myself am gonna head out now. So, St. Petersburg. I know Carl has left. Chris Massey, Lord Sathian, Scott, if you're still here. Damn, wait, Scott, are you still here? I just saw your text about saying you want to do the Frontier mod. Because I'm actually in that mod. I'm in that mod. I do a voice for one of the characters. I recorded my lines like 5 years ago, though. But I'm in there. I think he's gone. Always. Likewise. Adios. Peace out, everybody. Take care of yourselves. Take care of each other. Love you all, and good night. And remember... Oh, I fucked it up.